My name is Temi Topaya.
I'm Tola.
I'm Tayo.
Toying.
She's so
just tell me.
Go back there.
You guys are all professionals.
Of course.
You're like this.
Without trying to start so spiritual, can I just read something from the Bible? Galatians 3:28. And it says, sorry.
Maybe we should define it first before we go into.
Okay, you want to define it?
I think Tola had a definition.
Okay, yeah, I'll define feminism. It's the belief that women and men should have equal rights and opportunities, organized activity on behalf of women's rights and interests. That's what feminism is.
Okay, I think that's a good point, and I just to read the Bible passage back that up. It says in Galatians 3:28 that there is neither Jew nor Greek, neither is there slave nor free, there is neither male nor female, for all of you are one in Christ Jesus.
Woo!
So
I like that.
Yeah. So I think coming from that perspective, it shows that it's not a competition. Men have their place, women have their place. Everybody should be allowed to flourish in their place. There's no. There's no you come before me because I'm a man or because you're a woman. So that's my take. I should be allowed to express myself and be free in who I am. You have instances, particularly from the African background, where you have people say, oh, you're a woman. Why? You understand? Like, I see being a woman is a disease. It's being a woman is not why, what, it should not be a reason why I don't do certain things. It should be because I want to do it or I don't want to do it, not because of my gender.
I think personally for me, I think it's more of a culture thing. Like our culture has since there's so much belief in women are here, men are there. As a woman, you don't do this. As a man, you should be here. Women, this is your place in the house. Men, this is your place in the house. And I think that stigma is really eating deep into the society, and that's why a lot of women are standing up right now. They're talking and they're speaking out more about what they think women's rights should be. At the same time, I also think that there's been so much noise about it. It's becoming so much noise. Sorry, that's my personal opinion. There's so much noise about it that it's becoming an issue. Like women are now trying to say, oh, we're above men, we are below men, or something. I think everyone has their place in society. There's no competition. As you said, there's neither Jew nor Greek, male nor female. We are all one in Christ.
Yeah, and I totally agree with you. I think trying to just obviously bring it home. I remember. I'll never forget a story I heard when I was in uni of this lady who had literally, because she was of marriageable age. I think she was 30, late 30s, almost 40s, and she had been told by older ones or our parents or family and the rest of that she even though she had a very good career, she shouldn't go out, she shouldn't buy a house, she shouldn't buy a car, she shouldn't do anything. Just literally try and live a almost a mediocre lifestyle just to so that she can attract the right man, because if she's too successful, the man for her would not come. And she literally lived that life for many years, and I think it was her 39th birthday, she just told herself that, you know what, enough is enough, if I'm going to be single all my life.
It's not a movie,
it was actually a story. On her 39th birthday, she decided that if she's going to be single, she might as well live a good single life. She apparently went to buy a house in, this is back in Nigeria, I heard the story, and she said that she bought a house in one of the luxurious areas. Lo and behold, the year after, she was married to the man that was actually opposite, that owned the house, opposite that house. So where she had been thinking, living a life, and I think it's just trying to bring that story, it's just trying to say, we all need to live to our optimal, the fullness of life. We all have an assignment God has called us for, and I think that everyone should be mindful of the fact that whilst I'm a wife, whilst I'm a mother, I still have my life, I have my assignment, I have what God has called me for, and I need to make sure I am living to the fullness of that. So that's my take on that.
Yeah,
I think I agree with you. I think a woman has a place in the society, a man has his place in the society. The reason why you do something or don't do something should not be because of your gender. No one is fighting for a position, no one is fighting for a role. You are a man, you are a woman, do what you need to do and, you know, go for it. Your gender should not stop you. And all this fighting, feminism, men are this or women are this, for me, it's just totally uncalled for. You don't need to make noise about it. Just go for it, do what you need to do. And then within the family setting, where you have the husband and the wife, the husband has his role, the wife has her role. And there is no competition, there is no rivalry, there is no, you know, you are one together. The husband is the head, the wife is the helpmate, and feminism and all of that should not, I don't know, there's just so much noise about it. And personally, I just think a man is a man, a woman is a woman. Do what you need to do, do what God has called you to be, and be all you can be. Gender should not stop you, gender should not define you.
Just to say something, I'm not sure about the noise part. I know people are trying to raise awareness, more like letting people, because a lot of ladies, a lot of women have been suppressed, they their voices are not being heard, and they've been doctored and be indoctrinated to believe that they are lesser than their male counterpart. So it's not necessarily, I wouldn't say it's noise, but it's just the awareness of who we are and leading to the fullness of life, of our life. If we keep quiet, like women have kept, like some, like we, that, like it has been for a few years, you find that the same things keep happening. You can't keep doing the same thing and expect a difference. Yeah. So people are speaking up to let people know that we have rights, we are human beings, we have brains, and we can be who we are without posing a threat to the to our male counterparts. Mm-hmm. And we should be allowed to be what we need to be.
I think I agree with everything you were saying, or everything everyone have said, but where I kind of have an issue, like with the old feminism thing, is when people bring it into the home and then they kind of, you want to do the same thing a man is doing. Like as Tola said, you know, a man has his role, like a woman has a role. And as a Christian, and if you're a Christian as well, you know, that's where the Bible, like, you know, says, you know, a man is the head of the home. And I think that that should be followed in the home. You know what I'm saying? Okay, a man is the head of the home, and that should be what it is. And a woman is the helpmate. If both of us are head, like, two people really can't be like the sailor. You can't have two sailors like on the same ship, right? Well, two captains on the same ship. So yeah, I just feel like, you know, when with all the noise, well, you're right in the terms of like, if you're raising awareness about something that's going on, I get that. But I feel like all of these things that maybe some people misunderstanding and bring all of that aggression, almost to they bring it to the home, and you want it. It's like you're fighting again. I guess it's just going back to not knowing your place and not knowing what God has called you to be, or who God has called you to be. There's nothing wrong like with being a helpmate, or being the, or letting the man lead as God has said it should be. Again, we can get into the discussion of, you know, what does it mean to lead?
I was going to say, do you have any examples in terms of
like everyone is just fighting anyway. I'm trying not to sound too controversial, but I just feel like, you know, when it comes to, when we get into like the home, a man has his place, and we shouldn't, as women,
a woman has her place,
and a woman has her place, and the man is the head, and there shouldn't be any contention about it. Except you're not Christian and you don't follow the Bible, then maybe you have your own rules or you make it up as you go, then that's fine. But I'm just speaking as a Christian woman, and this is just what I believe.
I don't think all men actually understand that it's when in the marriage, that exactly is in the context of marriage. They take it outside of marriage. I remember when I was in university, I studied a male-dominated course, and if I wanted some, I remember somebody say something quite contrary because I was speaking about, like, and mentioned, in fact, referred to me as because I was a lady. Like, excuse me, that reference to being submissive or whatever is just for my husband. Mm. At this point that we're speaking, we are counterparts, we're colleagues, and you don't. The fact that you're a man doesn't make you any better than me. When I get to my married home and I decide, and that's a different thing. But a lot of men don't understand that you go to the workplace and because you have a female boss, if you can't, you're struggling to submit to what, because she is a woman. Mm-hmm. And it's just the way we've been, a lot of men, African men or in other cultures, have been brought up to believe that they are superior and she's just a woman. Or I remember a colleague, one of my colleagues the other day, he has a daughter. And it was like, oh, like if he has to have a son to carry on the name. I said, what name? I said, okay, what do you expect my father to do? He has 5 girls, so there's
five
no name.
5 girls, yeah, man.
So I'm like, this is a thing that they've been sold down generations. People selling us ideas or that, telling us, making us believe what they believe. I'm like, we need to wake up, not in this day and age.
Yeah, when I'm talking about the noise, like recently we were talking about something on one group, and I saw people who were writing things like, it's a woman's world, at the end of the day, it's a woman's world, and I'm like, man's world? Okay, and then someone I responded and asked,
a woman's world.
Someone I responded and asked, okay, right now we're fighting the fact that everybody says it's a man's world, right? So when it becomes a woman's world, then the men start fighting back. Is that what she wants? So that's what I mean, you know, like, I think a lot of people, there's the awareness part. And then some people are going overboard and trying to lord. Everybody has their place, and then we're all into fulfill God's plans for our lives as individuals, male or female, as the case may be. I think that basically sums everything we've said so far.
Yeah, I think the final screen being drawn back to what Tosin said. I think in terms of the going back to when family and the marriage structure, I think if each individual knows their place, it makes it a lot easier. If a man knows he's the head and knows that he's got a very supportive wife, knows he's got a wise woman as well, would always, obviously, not always, in most cases, seek our opinion or something, rather than not saying, oh, the man is there, so whatever he says, you go ahead with it. I'm not saying that's what you're trying to say.
I think part of leadership qualities from a man is also carrying you.
I believe that in most cases, if the man is acting in space as their head and carrying on, it makes it easier for the woman to be submissive, as against just you having to just.
I think the Bible says it perfectly. The man should love the woman. Should love his wife. If a man loves his wife, it will be easy peasy to submit to a man that loves you. You don't need, it won't be stressful at all. So I think
if a man doesn't love his wife,
it's not a traditional role. It makes it harder. Men love your wives, women submit to your husbands. Even the Bible also says submit one to another. That's coming for another day. Just men fulfill your roles, women fulfill your roles as an individual, and live a full life. That's ultimately, I think that's what our take home will be. Live a full life. Fulfill what God has called you to be, and know who you are in Christ, know who you are in God. Doesn't matter whether you're male or female, there's so much more you can do with your life, and just be the best version of yourself, basically.
Don't feel less than, because
I drop a line out there for girls, ladies, women, female species, whatever you call yourself, can we all try to live our fullness? Let's not make this an excuse, because I have met lots of women that make the excuse the fact that their men are not being allowing them, they've suppressed them. I'm not saying it's the easiest thing, but do make sure this is not your excuse for not living a full life, for not doing what you've been called for not leaving a mark on this earth. Everyone will be called, their mood would answer to what they've been done on earth.
Yep. Thank you very much, guys. It was lovely. Thank you for watching us. Make sure you like you like this video, subscribe and comment down below. Yeah. See you next
and
video.
Share.
Thank
you.
Bye.
Bye.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.